the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. I welcome you all for this Sunday worship service. May God bless us through this worship. And today being the Independence Day, I wish all of you a happy Independence Day as India celebrates 75th Independence Day. Shall we all bow our heads and look to God in prayer? Gracious God and loving Father, we commit ourselves before you as we give you honor and praises this morning, O Lord. And we thank you, Lord, for all the leaders, those who fought for India's independence from Britishers. Today we are able to govern by ourselves. We are able to move freely wherever we like. And we come and pray that the whole nation will continually experience this great independence the days to come. Now we commit, as we begin this worship service, we commit each and every one of us into your mighty hand, O Lord. Guide us, lead us, and help us to understand your word, by your word, so that we'll be able to journey further in our spiritual journey. In Christ's mighty name, we pray. Amen. By following the second order of worship. Let us worship God. God is spirit. Those who worship, we must worship in spirit and truth. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Grace, mercy, and peace will be with us from God the Father, from Jesus Christ, the Father's Son, in truth and love. Let everyone who is thirsty come. Let anyone who wishes take the water of life as a gift. The Lord is near to all who call on Him, to all who call on Him in truth. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall sing forth your praise. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. As it was the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Adoration of the Trinity. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Glory be to you, O Lord, Most High. Blessed is he who has come and is to come in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, O God. Holy are you, O God. Holy are you, Almighty. Holy are you, Almighty. Holy are you, O Immortal. Holy are you, O Immortal. O Lord, our Redeemer, who was crucified for us, have mercy upon us. O Lord, our Redeemer, who was crucified for us, have mercy upon us. O Lord, Holy Spirit, have mercy upon us. O Lord, Holy Spirit, have mercy upon us. O Lord, accept our praise and praises and have mercy upon us. O Lord, have compassion and mercy upon us. Let us enter into the act of confession. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves. The truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he who is faithful and just will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. I'll get up and go to my Father, and I'll say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. The time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but we have one who in every respect has been tested as we are, yet without sin. Therefore, let's all kneel and examine ourselves in silence. Let us humbly confess our sins to the Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful God, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we should have done. And we have done those things which we should not have done. And there is no health in us. But you, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare them, O God, who confess the faults. Restore them that are penitent according to your promises declared to humankind. In Christ Jesus our Lord, and grant, O most merciful God, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and just life to the glory of your holy name. Amen. May the Almighty and merciful Lord grant us pardon and remission for all our sins, time for amendment of life, the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. Birthdays and wedding anniversaries for this week. 16th August 2021, Mrs. Divya Knight. 19th August, Mr. George Cherian, Mrs. and Mr. David Charles, Mrs. and Mr. Sanjay Zakaria are celebrating their wedding anniversaries. 20th August, Arun Joshua Thomas, Mrs. Ronnie Selvam. 21st August, De Gracia Dorcas Stanley. May God add all the manifold blessings to the members those celebrating their birthdays and wedding anniversaries. Shall we all bow our heads and look to God in prayer for these people? Gracious God and loving Father, we commit and pray for all the members who celebrated their birthdays this week as they enter into New Year. May God Almighty grant all the manifold blessings upon them so that they'll be able to rejoice in the Lord always and bring you honor and glory. We also commit and pray for the couples who will be celebrating their wedding anniversaries this week. Be with them, O Lord, in their family life as they enter into New Year. Let God Almighty continue to journey with them so that they'll be able to receive blessings from you and have more happiness and peaceful life in their family life. Bless their children and family members. We also come to pray for all the members, those who are praying unto you, giving thanks to you for all the benefits that they have been received in the past. Continue to bless them for your glory. In Christ's mighty name, we pray. Amen.
We must go as a light to the nations. Take up his cross and follow where he leads. We must go as the light to the nations. Prepare to wear his crown of thorns, to bring his peace.
Cast your cares upon him, lay your life upon him, for only he is worthy to stand. In tribulation, trials and sorrows, when you can't see through tomorrow, he'll reveal to you the frailty of a man. Cast your cares upon him, lay your life upon him, for only he is worthy to stand. In tribulation, trials and sorrows, when you can't see through tomorrow, reveal to you the frailty.
To love your neighbor, will they see the sweet, sweet Savior shining through the charity you give? Do you hear his call to follow? You must lay down your life to follow humility, cast down your. We must go as a light to the nations. Take up his cross and follow where he leads. We must go as a light to the nations. Prepare to wear his cross. Cares upon him, lay your life upon him, his faithfulness, love, who's always there. Do you hear his call to follow? You must lay down your life to follow. crown of thorns to bring his peace.
Today's reading is taken from Romans chapter 6, verses from 1 to 14. Romans chapter 6, being read at verse 1. What then are we to say? Should we continue in sin in order that grace may abound? By no means. How can we who died to sin go on living in it? Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body of sin might be destroyed and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. Therefore, do not let sin exercise dominion in your mortal bodies to make you obey their passions. No longer present your members to sin as instruments of wickedness, but present yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death to life, and present your members to God as instruments of righteousness. For sin will have no dominion over you, since you are not under law, but under grace. Here ends the reading. Thanks be to thee, O God.
Here in the love of Christ I stand.
Grace and peace to you all from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's pray. Gracious God and loving Father, we all belong to one family as we are saved by the blood of Jesus Christ. And today, as we are gathered in your name to hear your voice and meditate upon your word, speak to us, mold us, strengthen us through your word, enlighten with your word, so that we'll be able to live a godly life here on this earth. In Christ's mighty name, we pray. Amen. Greetings to you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Again, it's a joy and honor for me to stand before you to bring God's word this Sunday. The theme given for us, according to CSI lectionary, is that baptism, dying and rising up with Christ. Baptism, : dying and rising up with Christ. And today we also, the India also celebrates its 75th Independence Day. As we meet our own people, as we meet family members, let us wish one another Happy Independence Day. So I would like to wish all of you Happy Independence Day. What a joy for us to be free from a British rule, free from a slavery rule, free from foreigners rule. Is it not a joy for us that we ourselves, we are able to govern, we ourselves, we are able to run our government, we ourselves able to make policies, principles, frame policies and make alteration to the constitution, and we are able to do whatever we like? Are we not happy with that? Yes, of course, we do have other difficulty in this democracy setup, but at the same time, most of us, we also feel that we are able to govern by ourselves. So the freedom means responsibility. So with responsibility, we are able to enjoy the freedom that is given by our, which has been gifted by our forefathers or our freedom fighters like Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Subhash Chandra Bose, Dr. Ambedkar, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, and there are many people, Kodikatha Kumaran, Tirupur Kumaran, Veerapandiya Kattabomman, and there are many people who really struggled for the good of our Indian nation people. So we are able to be free from all the foreign rule, from British rule. And we are able to move around, we are able to walk around, we are able to think, we are able to have our life here on this, this land, Indian nation. So when we celebrate India's independence, 75th India's Independence Day, let us also remember the freedom fighters, let us also give thanks to God for all the efforts that have been taken, all the suffering they have underwent. And we also know very well that there are many people who really died because to have a free life, to have a freedom life here in this great nation India, in Bharat. So if at all some people would have not shed their blood for all of us, if they would have not died because for the cause of freedom, and we today would have not been able to enjoy this independence. So also, when we compare the same thing with in our spiritual journey, we are also as per the theme, we are also expected that our dying and rising up with Christ is very, very important. No, we have to die. We have to die and rise up with Christ. Dying is not just physically, but dying for sin. So I would like to concentrate from Romans chapter 6 and verse 1 to 14, where we are able to learn many things. Now, first I would like to bring 3-point sermon today, but before that I would like to also read from Ephesians chapter 4 verse 5. It says, we read that one Lord, one faith and one baptism. So if we are baptized by Jesus Christ, if we feel that we are baptized by the Lord Jesus Christ, and we must affirm that there is only one God who is our Lord Jesus Christ, there is only one faith, that is on faith on Jesus Christ and the Lord Almighty, one baptism in the name of Jesus Christ that we all undergo. So baptism is very important for all our Christians, you know, for all the Christian peoples. And also I would like to state my first point as freedom from sin. Freedom from sinful life. How do we get freedom from sinful life? Because unless we die to sin, we cannot get freedom. So as we read from Romans chapter 9, it says, chapter 6, verse 3, "Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life." So in order to walk in newness of life, we must die ourselves for the sin. We must die with Christ, because we must, once we allow ourselves to die for our sin, then we are raised with Christ for newness of life, for new life, for the life-giving spirit. Life-giving spirit comes from the Lord Almighty. So, and also we have been united with him in a death like this, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like this. So, baptism in the church is the most radical instrument of liberation. That's what I always feel, that baptism is the most instrument, most powerful instrument for a powerful instrument or a powerful tool for liberation. Liberation for women, liberation for children. Because the baptism only enabled women and children to be part of this greater faith community. So this is a gift of God passed on to us by Jesus Christ, and by whom it was introduced for all the human beings to experience God's reign, a way to be part of the kingdom of God here on this earth. So my dear friends, as we listen to the word of God, God speaks very clearly that baptism enables us to be free from our sinful nature. Not only frees us from our sinful nature, and also it enables other people, it enables the downtrodden, it enables women, it enables people, those who are deprived, to be part of this great wider faith community. And we also must make a note here that we are all united in this baptism. Now, when we read from Acts chapter 2, verse 41, we read that when apostles preached the word of God, there were about 3,000 people baptized on the same day. This baptism was towards baptism was for repentance and for the forgiveness of sin. So baptism of repentance and for the forgiveness of sin. And also when we say that we must die to our sinful nature, we must die for Christ, which means we are allowing we are allowing ourselves to make to flourish the flourish Christianity here on this earth in more positive way. Now, as we read from John's Gospel 12, verse 20. John's Gospel, let me read for you. John's Gospel 12, verse 23. I'll read it for you. The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very, very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. So the wheat must die itself for the benefit of others. So if Jesus did not allow himself to undergo all this passion and suffering, and we were not able to enjoy this freedom from sin. No, we are able to enjoy this freedom. We are free from enslavement of sin because of Jesus Christ's sacrificial death on the cross of Calvary, is it not? So recently, we all know, most of us would have read the letter which was written by Mrs. Gladys Staines, to her son, after 20 years of the Staines and the children, they were burnt alive. And she mentions very clearly, "My son, because of your death, and because of your death, that because you have been given as a seed, you have died, because of that, today we could witness more people getting know about Jesus Christ. More people are becoming closer to Jesus Christ. More people are committing themselves to Jesus Christ, accepting Jesus as their personal savior in the region of Orissa. And there are many people remember the sacrificial work that has been done. So there is a joy in heaven." That's what she is trying to write, Mrs. Gladys Staines. And she also quotes this verse also, says that unless a grain of wheat falls onto the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. So she is very happy about what had happened. In fact, maybe, of course, physically there is a great loss, but spiritually she gains so much, because there are many people who are turning into Christ, who are coming to know the love of Jesus Christ. So, and when we look at this, "For if we have been united with him in a death like this, like his, we will certainly be united with him in his resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that the body of sin might be destroyed and we might no longer be enslaved to sin." The old self must go away from us. It is not that how many times we go to church. It is not that how many times we sing praises. It is not that how many hours we spend time in prayer. But it matters whether the old self has gone and the new self has been reigning in our life. Now, as we read from 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 15, it says, "In Christ old things has gone and new things have come in." So if new things really has come in, then you must have a newness of life, because you have been died with Christ. As Jesus Christ died for all our sins, if we also die for our sin, for our sinful nature, then we are free from our sinful nature. And when we talk about baptism, in baptism, I said free from sinful nature. And in baptism, we are also, we are free from law, but we are under grace. We are free from law, but we are under grace. How to understand about this? As we read from Romans chapter 6, verse 14, it says, I'll read from 13 also, 12 onwards. "Therefore do not let sin exercise dominion in your mortal bodies to make you obey their passions. No longer present your members to sin as instruments of wickedness, but present yourself to God as those who have been brought from death to life, and present your members to God as instruments of righteousness. For sin will have no dominion over you," because you are being saved by Christ, because you made yourself to die with Christ for the newness of life, for the resurrection of life. So here it says, "For sin will have no dominion over you, since you are not under law but under grace." So we are no longer under law, no longer under commandments that it binds us, no, with all conditions, this and that, and we are not able to move. At times, no, people say, no, you have to go by this. No, at times people also question Jesus Christ, asking, no, what about Moses? What about the commandments of Moses? Why are you doing like this? Why are you not behaving like this? Why are you making all these alterations in the church or in the synagogue? Why are you approaching no common people? Why are you moving with no the lepers? Why are you healing people no on Sabbath day? These are all the questions raised by the Pharisees and Sadducees or the priestly class people. But Jesus encounters and says, no, we are not under law. No, law was created to set people in a right path for goodness of people. If the same law binds in some way or the other for the benefit of not for the benefit of human beings, then law doesn't control, but it is the grace which gives us freedom to move around, to do good and to spread the gospel of good news that Jesus Christ has died for all of us, and his blood frees us from the enslavement of sin. So here he says very clearly, Paul makes it very clearly to the church at Rome. He says, since you are not under law but under grace, so no longer the sin will have dominion over you. So your old self must go away from you. Your new self should be there, so that you will also experience that God is with you and God is sailing with you in your spiritual journey. No, it doesn't mean how you are taking baptism. Some people would say, no, we are taken baptism by the river. And some people even they would say, we went by flight directly to Israel. We landed there and we took baptism in the Jordan River. So we are very much cleansed. We are free from sin because we took baptism, the same river where Jesus also took baptism, the same river where people of faith, people of the saints, other saints have taken baptism. So we are immersed in that same water. So we are free from sin. Is that okay? If you go to some river, or if you go to some place where you can really immerse yourself, and then become when you come out of the river, the water, you are saved. Is that quantity of water which really makes your life perfect? And some people would say, sprinkle baptism is it is not at all acceptable. And if you have a sprinkle baptism, you will not go to heaven. If you want to enter to heaven, go to the water, go to the flowing water. Don't go to the still water. Go to the river and be baptized. Then you will be directly taken to heaven. At times, what happens? It's like lemon. When you put a lemon into the glass of water, and after a week you take and see, the lemon, the water will be the same taste because the lemon is not cut. And only when you cut the lemon and when you put a drop of a lemon juice into it, then the taste differs. You will see the difference. So also, it is not that how many times we are dipped into the water, it is not the quantity of water, but it is the quality of life, the newness of life. The old self should go away from us and the new self should come, and we must see that we die ourselves for the sake of Christ so that we will be able to have a good life. And thirdly, I would like to say, first I said free from sin. No, dying and rising with Christ means free from sin. Then free from law. And finally, I would like to say, because you are free from sin, you are free from law, now you are united with Christ for eternity. You are united with Christ for eternity. So in that, we must become Christ-centered people. In that renewal, there is no longer Greek, no longer a Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbarian or Scythian, slave and free, but Christ is all and in all. When you say that you are Christ-centered people, then you should not, you are not expected to see the differences. You are not expected to segregate people in the name of caste, in the name of creed, in the name of color, in the name of whatnot. And in today, church is very bad to witness that when we say that we are all united by the blood of Christ, we are all Christ-centered people, we all sing hallelujah, we all come to the holy sanctuary and sing praises. But many churches, even today, at times the churches are becoming communal churches. No, church meant for a particular community, the other church meant for a particular community. There will be same denominational church in the same street, but you will have two churches. Why? Because they would say, no, this church is for the downtown community, the other church is for the other community people. No, Bible doesn't teach. Jesus very clearly says, in baptism we are all united. And Paul makes it very clear, in Christ, once you have accepted Christ, there is no Greek, there is no Jew, there is no slave, there is no master, there is no men, there is no women. So we are all coming together, and we all come out of our differences, and we are trying to make one common community where Christ empowers all of us, and Christ's rule is very much enforced. If that is the case, then we all can really envision about the eternal life. If we all say that we are going to be in the heaven forever with Jesus Christ, who is sitting on the throne as a lamb, sacrificial lamb, who is there. If we all say that we are all going to the heaven, then we must also see that we are all Christ-centered people, not linguistic oriented, or not community oriented, or not ethnicity oriented, not individualist oriented, but for the life of Christ and towards the eternal life, we must all strive towards as one community of believers. And at times, people also think they are not able to find Christ. It is not finding Christ, but making ourselves to be controlled by Jesus Christ, by the Holy Spirit. It so happened that there were in a river, a pastor was giving baptism to many. And there was a person who came there. He was a drunken person, and he was just roaming there, and was also stumbling to get baptism. And pastor called him and asked him, "Do you want to be baptized?" He said, "Yes, I want to be baptized." So he dipped him into the water and came out. And pastor asked, "Were you able to find Jesus? Have you found Jesus?" He said, "No." Then again, the pastor dipped him for second time. And then he asked, "Have you found Jesus?" He said, "No." And third time again he found, and he said, no, I'm not able to find Jesus. And third time he asked, the drunkard person asked the question, again to pastor, asking, "I was not able to find Jesus here, but I want to ask one question. Did Jesus fell here in this water?" My dear friends, at times we are not able to understand that water is not so important, but life is so important. The word baptismo, the Greek word baptismo, means to sprinkle or immersion, both. Whether you are immersed, whether you are sprinkled, doesn't matter. But it is the quality of life is more important. Are you controlled by the blood of Jesus Christ? Are you controlled by the principle of Jesus Christ? Or is your life is controlled by the teachings of Jesus Christ? Is your life is fully given to Jesus Christ for the fuller life, to experience fuller life, or to experience the fullness of life in Jesus Christ? That matters a lot. So we all believe that Jesus Christ is going to come again, right? In Parousia, second coming is going to happen. And when Jesus Christ is going to come, he's going to expect that how many times you have taken baptism, or where you have taken baptism, or in which place. No, doesn't matter. Were you able to die with Christ and to lift up and raise up for the sake of Christ? That is more important. So my dear friends, as we listen to the word of God, let us commit ourselves and ask, am I able to die myself and rise up with Christ for eternity, because as I said, dying with Christ now helps us free from our sinful life, and secondly, free from law, but we are under grace of Jesus Christ, and thirdly, we are able to see that we are all united with Christ, and we all become Christ-centered life. We are able to lead a Christ-centered life. If that is the case, shall we all now commit ourselves and say, Lord, today we would like to commit ourselves and see that we are united for Lord Almighty, Lord Jesus Christ. Shall we all bow our heads and look to God in prayer? Gracious God, we acknowledge your grace and compassion upon us. We thank you for the sacrament of baptism, which unites us in Christ, bringing life from death to sin and raises us up from newness of life. Enlighten us to grow up in this understanding so that we can witness your grace that enables us to partake in Christ for new possibilities of relationship and reconciliation. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you, and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and ever. Amen. Let us affirm our faith by saying the Apostles' Creed together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended to heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, the life everlasting. Amen. Prayers. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Let us say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let's continue to pray for world peace. O God, who is the author of peace and lover of concord, in whose knowledge our eternal life stands, whose service is perfect freedom, defend us, your humble servants, from all assaults of evil, that we, surely trusting in your defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray for God's grace. O Lord, our refuge, almighty and everlasting God, who safely brought us to the beginning of this day, defend us in the same with your mighty power, and grant that this day we fall into no sin, neither run into any kind of danger, but that all our doings may be ordered by your governance, to do always that which is righteous in your sight, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us continue to pray. O gracious God and loving Father, we commit ourselves on this auspicious day for our nation, as India celebrates 75th Independence Day, we recommit ourselves that we will work for the betterment of our greater nation, India. And we also remember all the freedom fighters, people like Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, Dr. Ambedkar, and Tirupur Kodikatha Kumar Veerapande Kattabomman, and many other people, those who fought against the slavery rule and got independence in this land. As we celebrate 75th India's independence, help us to be more responsible towards our freedom that we have received. So also, Lord, we commit ourselves as we celebrate the freedom from our sinful life, as we are independent from our wickedness, but dependent upon the grace of Jesus Christ. Continually use us for your glory, as we are free from sin, as we are free from law, but under God's grace, under Jesus Christ's grace. And help us to be more Christ-centered always, because as we all expect the Messiah, second coming of Jesus Christ, to happen the days to come. We commit ourselves, help us to prepare to meet Jesus Christ in his second coming. We come and pray for all the members of St. Stephen's. We pray for elderly, women, youth, children, committing each and every one of them into your mighty hand, O Lord. We pray for the people, those who are working with government sector. We pray for the people, those who are working with educational institutions. And we pray for our people, those who are working with private sector. Bless each and every one of them as they put their labor, and bless them, O Lord. We also pray for children as they put all the efforts to study and get a better wisdom. Yes, Lord, grant your wisdom so that they'll be able to excel in their own studies. We also pray for our India Prime Minister, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, the President of India, and all the other ministers. And we also pray for all the state chief ministers, especially we come and pray for our Chief Minister, Mr. M.K. Stalin, and all the other cabinet ministers. We also come to pray for all the district collectors, all the police officials. Be with each and every one of them as they celebrate today. Yes, Lord, be with them and continue to guide them and grant your wisdom so that they'll be able to govern people in a good way. We also pray for missions, mission agencies, missionary organizations, and we pray for all the missionaries, those who are longing to spread the gospel of Christ as they live with Christ's salvation, as they spread the salvation of Christ to many, because Jesus Christ did not come for a particular community but came to save the whole world. He was called as World Redeemer by Samaritans, the village. Yes, Lord, we also believe and we also pray for all the missionaries. Continue to guide them and guard them in this difficult situation as they spread the gospel of Christ, the nook and corner of our state. We pray for churches. We pray for all the churches, especially for, we pray for CSI, CNI, Martham, and other fraternal churches. And we pray for all the bishops. We commit and pray for the diocese, the diocesan bishop, Bishop Omar, all the other offices, for the new administrative county members, as they take steps to convene the diocesan council. Be with them and guide them so that they'll be able to have good administration in the days to come. Let the people of God also experience the reign of God here in our own diocese. We commit and pray for all those who are participating in this worship service. Bless each and every individual and us families. Make them blessing to many, O Lord. In Christ's mighty name we pray. Amen. Let us receive benediction. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of the Father, and sweet come of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. May the good Lord continue to bless each and every one of you in the days to come as you are waiting to enter into a new week. May God bless all of you. Thank you. Thanks for joining with us to worship the Lord. May God bless all.